Hello, cooking enthusiasts. First off, a big thank you and welcome to any new subscribers. Today's video is all about ramen, and in particular, flavored ramen, because there's actually an interesting challenge related to that topic. When it comes to regular pasta and other forms of noodles, you've likely seen them in various colors and flavors, and I've made some flavored pasta myself. But with the exception of adding a few different types of flour, I've never seen flavored ramen noodles, and I know exactly why. What sets ramen apart from other noodles is that it's an alkaline dough, which means if you're going to make it from scratch or a restaurant makes it in-house, there's basically three ingredients: flour, water, and a strong alkaline or chemical base. Japanese chefs sometimes have a traditional alkaline substance they use called kansui, but many guides for making ramen at home will simply recommend converting sodium bicarbonate into sodium carbonate in the oven, which is a much stronger chemical base. Now, the alkaline is necessary because it modifies the starches and the proteins in the flour, making the resulting noodle a bit more resilient to the hot soup and helping it stay together. However, this ingredient also prevents us from flavoring the noodle. This strong alkaline is also going to react with anything we attempt to flavor our noodle with. It'll either create very off flavors or, at the very least, prevent our starches from being modified enough. Fortunately, I have come up with a solution, although it's a bit roundabout. We have to pre-treat the flour with the alkaline in order to create the desirable chemical reactions before we even make the dough. Essentially, what this involves is creating a low moisture but very alkaline dough, and then dehydrating it back down into a flour. This might seem a little counterintuitive, but we're allowing the alkaline to create the desirable modifications to the starch and the proteins in the flour, but our final dough won't actually have any alkaline in it. So this is my current procedure for making pre-treated ramen flour. You'll need some form of high gluten wheat flour. I used whole wheat bread flour, but I recommend getting some white bread flour to start. For every 100 grams of flour, you'll need 30 grams or 30 mils of water and 2.5 grams of your sodium carbonate. Dissolve the sodium carbonate in the water first. You might need to warm it up slightly, and then combine it with your flour to make a very dry, crumbly dough. If possible, vacuum pack your dough for a few hours to ensure that the dough and the sodium carbonate have full contact. If you don't, simply wrap the dry dough tightly in plastic wrap and let it rest for several hours. After the resting period, you want to break apart your dough into small pebble-sized pieces and place it into a parchment-lined dehydrator set at its lowest setting. I just let mine run overnight. The next day, you want to take your now dehydrated dough and weigh it. If there's more mass relative to your starting amount of flour, you need to dehydrate it a little longer. If there's actually less mass than your starting amount of flour, then add a little fresh flour to bring you back to your starting point. We are in the final stretch. For every 100 grams of starting flour, I also added 10 grams of fresh flour at the end and 10 grams of rice flour in addition to 1.2 grams of salt before blending everything together and sifting it. On screen are all the amounts for a 600 gram batch of ramen flour. If you have any questions, please let me know, and next week I will be actually discussing making ramen noodles with this flour. Thank you for watching.